sponsor.
I wish. Man. Oh, man. Do I wish. What's going on, ladies and gents? Dalibor here for T3G, along with...
Harris.
And today we're going to do something we haven't done in a while.
In a while.
It's been a minute and a half.
Although it will be coming up again soon.
Yeah. Half season's coming up.
Half season's coming
up. But... the entire season of Jessica Jones dropped. We have finished it. We actually finished marathoning it this morning, last night.
Yeah, it was 6 o'clock
when I went to sleep. And we're just going to share our opinions and our thoughts.
About the show.
This will be spoiler-filled, so...
yeah, there's going to be...
if you're not looking for spoilers, don't watch this.
Yeah, don't watch this if you're not... if you don't want
to
hear anything.
Let's try to keep this a little more organized than we normally do. Let's talk about... characters.
Okay.
How characters are portrayed.
Alright.
Acting.
Okay.
I'll start with the story.
Alright.
So let's look at the overall story. And then we'll talk about the actual writing, dialogue, that kind of stuff.
Okay.
Okay.
Alright.
So, characters.
Right.
I like the character of Jessica Jones.
Yeah.
I've known her only from a little bit of comics, what little she had to do with Civil War in the comics, what little she had to do with Secret Invasion, just like little pieces of where she was just kind of like Luke Cage's in the Avengers. She also happens to be there because they're married, because she's got a baby at one point. So
right.
She's just there. She's like an ancillary character. So that's, I really didn't know much about her per se. So this really kind of brought me in to her in like a full view.
Sure.
I think she's a cool character. I think it's done well on TV. I think it's a great character for TV because she's not all about her powers. She's more about the fact that she's just trying to live this life and happens to have powers. I think it works really well on TV. It works really well in the smaller format, smaller budget.
Yeah. Yeah, because, I mean...
oh, the last thing we'll talk about is the actual filming.
Sure.
Because we have some thoughts on that. I love Kilgrave. I do wish that at some point, at least at the end, get like have him turn purple when he died.
Well, that's
something.
What we were expecting. We were expecting, okay, the full dose was going to turn him purple, right?
Like there's purple serum.
Give me everything. Oh, okay.
And they gave you a little bit when he like yelled. His veins were going purple, right? And I get that. That's cool. But I wish that he would have just gone full purple, even just for a minute. You know, even just for a minute.
You can do it. There's ways of doing it really good.
Sure.
I mean, he doesn't have to be fully purple, but certain aspects can be purple.
Right. It could have just been a portion of his face.
Right. It could have been just constant, maybe even veins or whatever.
Yeah.
Like,
there was just ways to do it that, I think early on I was saying if... maybe his eyes were purple when he used his power.
Right.
They kind of like...
And then other people, you know.
I think that there was opportunities missed on that as far as his appearance.
But Kilgrave as a character in general.
The character
is really good.
Insanely good. I think it's a good departure from the comics. In the comics, he's a little more maniacal, a little more kind of just in your face. I'm going to control you. You're going to do whatever I want. And, you know, if we get caught, whatever.
Right.
Now, if I get caught,
he didn't want
to
get caught.
Yeah, here he wasn't trying to get caught. He wasn't even trying to deal with anyone. He would just tell people to forget him, tell people that he just was never there.
Right.
So, I like how they did it. I like his origin. I don't like that they held out for so damn long to give us the origin. It was like probably eight episodes in.
It was either episode 8 or 9 where we learned about...
and it was like, okay, well, finally. Because it was the same thing with Jessica, because it does kind of follow, from what I read... I read on Wikipedia, again, I don't know much about her.
Right.
But it does kind of follow her comic book origin. But at the same time, it's like, why did it take 9 episodes to give us that?
I mean...
Because we barely got any kind of flashbacks and stuff like that, so I just thought that was interesting. But I did like that we saw that. I like Luke Cage. I think there's really not much you can say about Luke Cage. I think he was done well. I think he was portrayed well.
Yeah.
There's clearly something else going on. He, you know, when the cop showed up, he's like, I gotta go. I can't be here. My name's not on the lease.
Right.
So there's something more which will probably lead into the Luke Cage series. But I think overall he was done well. I didn't like the neighbor chick. really at all. the girl of the two twins.
It was just annoying.
Yeah, both of them were just kind of... It was... I feel like they just shoved him in there to have that victim in, like, episode seven or eight or whatever.
Yeah, absolutely.
And, you know, it was like, oh, we need a victim, so we need somebody that we know that's not just, like, nobody. So we're going to include these, like, really annoying characters right off the bat. Mm-hmm. So... And then you had the junkie friend who turned out to not be a junkie. I thought he was a cool character. I thought he would have been cooler if maybe the... Because I feel like he got over being a heavy drug addict
right. In,
like, 3 days.
Yeah, it went fast.
It was like was one like episode, he's like, no, I'm not going to take these drugs.
He couldn't look
And the next
straight.
Episode, he was like,
yeah,
shit, man, this is rough.
Right.
Whereas, from what I've seen on, like, Law and Order, and, like, from what I heard
Takes a lot.
It's like, violent shakes, you almost die, you need... She gave him, like, a bottle of water?
A bottle of water.
I was like... You need, like, gallons. You just run the tap. Like, he's going to need a lot more than that. He's going to be sweating bullets. But no. It was just, like, this one bottle of water and his, like, strong decision to just, like, knock over the drugs into the toilet. And I was like, I applaud that. Right. And I'm glad it gave her that little bit of hope. But I don't know.
But, I mean, as a character, I enjoyed him. I liked the character in this story. I think he made more sense than the twins did. He actually had a decent story, and we'll get into that, but I liked him as a character. I thought it was a good character. From what we understand, he's not
anything out of comics
or anything like that. He's just a character for the series.
For an original character, right. I think he's a really cool addition.
Yeah, exactly. You know, what you said about Jessica Jones, I think she overall is a very good character to portray on TV. I don't think she's a movie thing. She could be a movie thing if she's like a background character that's just
she might like find out something about
Civil
somebody.
War or, you know, Infinity Gauntlet or whatever you want to do. Yeah. Like, all that stuff would be cool to see these characters kind of play in the background.
Yeah.
Which just makes the universe bigger, which would, especially for something like Civil War, make sense because it did involve the whole thing.
Yeah, I think that would be fantastic to see that, to have them just kind of like in the middle of a fight, you know, Cap gets knocked into an alley where, you know, the Daredevil's in there, he like helps him up.
Right, right.
And he's fighting a guy, and it's like, all right, cool, all right, let's move on with our lives.
Yeah, yeah, no, absolutely. Overall, I mean, I don't have really major issues with any of the characters that were really in there. I mean, I didn't care for the twins. I really got annoyed with the whole, and we'll get into that whole story aspect of it, but with the whole chick twin and the whole, like, oh, let's rebel type of deal, but we'll get into that. So that was kind of annoying, but overall, I think all the characters just in this story were a good pick to play in the story. I mean, there was definitely a lot more than we expected, I think.
Yeah.
Just when it comes down to characters they used out of the comics, because the guy that was with Patsy, the cop.
The cop
he's
is Nuke.
Actually,
yeah,
he's Nuke. Yeah, which
yeah,
we
Nuke
didn't know until
there was
we
cool.
realized that it was
Patsy's
actually.
Patsy's character was done really well. I completely forgot about her. Like, although I shouldn't, because I think that was one of the best characters in the
definitely,
show.
Definitely, yeah. It was very well played, yeah.
And so you had those. You had the detective who... I found out is actually also from the original Alias comic, who is apparently a big part of the Alias comic, also gets killed.
The main detective.
If a major black character, like if an important black character gets killed on Luke Cage, I'm calling shenanigans.
I'm saying, because that's like, okay, so we had the black reporter that had
Ben
a pretty bad...
Ben
which
Urich
had an awesome...
To be,
which had an awesome story,
yeah.
And I loved the actor in Daredevil was great, but then he gets madly choked out, and then I even loved this guy as he was playing it, because he was like, okay, I'm a cop, but you know what, I get it, I get it, I understand now, and then
crazy.
I boom, right in the fucking dome.
He's like, listen, you guys go, I'm going to handle the evidence here. We're gonna do this.
And it's just,
and then just don't.
Wow.
That was rough.
Yeah, I didn't... I mean, I expected it because we saw it in Daredevil, but at the same time, I was hoping I was wrong.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
I wish they had kind of kept him on. I think not even speaking on, like, diversity, I think we just need more cooler secondary characters. Because now, you're down to, what, two? If you bring back the crazy twin. Because you have the friend who's now her assistant, which I thought was cool.
Right.
Kind of like a weak ending for him. I feel like not he kind of like no, fell know, into it just because like her apartment's a mess.
Here's the thing, the phone's ringing.
I'm gonna pick up the phone.
But at the same time, I don't think it's a weak ending for him because I think he made peace. You know, he was ready to leave her. He was ready to go.
That's true. He was ready to give up.
He made peace. He made peace, and he's like, you know what? I'm gonna stick around.
I'm gonna make a difference here.
So I think on that aspect for him, it wasn't a weak ending. I think. And we'll talk, once again, this is all story, but I think it's more, for me, it's more on Jessica Jones / Kilgrave style that was it could have been a little better, you know what I'm saying? But, I mean, when it comes down to talking about characters and characters used in the story, I think all of them were very well used, and I think all of them were good to see in the series. I think, like I said, the only ones, because they were, I think, original, were the twins. Which I didn't, like I said, I had no care for that, and we'll go into the story after.
Yeah.
What did you say was next on the list? So we talk
acting.
Characters?
Acting.
Okay.
I think the acting, so I think Jessica Jones, I think, did a good job.
I think she did a good job.
I think she did a better than okay job, so I want to say good job.
Yeah, she did a good job. I won't lie, as I told you, I didn't care for this actress, especially when she got announced.
She has a strange look.
She has a very strange look, and from what I've seen images of Jessica Jones, I didn't necessarily care for this actress to portray her. But she did a good job. I can't really say anything negative about it. It's not like her acting was bad or anything like that. Yeah, she did a good job.
Right.
I mean, that's really the most I can say. I wasn't mind blown or anything by it. She didn't do anything as an actress that really like hooked me to be like, yeah, you know, that's badass or something.
I think she did an overall good job. Like you said, there's nothing really stood out about the performance. Right. Nothing was really disappointing about it.
Right.
I don't think there's any part where I'm kind of like, oh, I don't know if I believe this scene. Or
right, whatever. Exactly.
I think she did a good job throughout. I think she did a consistently good job, you know, in the high notes, in the low notes, you know, happy, sad, all that kind of, the entire emotional spectrum. I think she handled it really well. I think Luke Cage was done well.
Here's all I have to say. I think the best actor is David.
I'm not even talking about him. That's why I haven't brought him up.
I'm going to talk about him. I think David Tennant took
David
the
Tennant's
show.
A ridiculous actor.
I saw him in Doctor Who, and just from that, I was like, you know, it's interesting. I want to see where this goes, because Doctor Who, if you watch it, like, it's not going to be amazing acting. It's cheesy, so like, it's never supposed to be like, oh my god, the acting is phenomenal. It's a cheesy show. So to see somebody like him playing a cheesy character to go into playing this sadistic, crazy, controlling menace, he took the show. Like, and for me, it's like every time you saw his scenes, he did a great job.
I think his story was a little weird.
His story,
I think he executed all the points of the story really well.
Right.
I think the whole
Kilgrave thing, as I told you, from what I knew he was just manipulative and he wants things his way. I knew that part. But the whole like, oh, Jessica, I need you in my life. I want you in my life.
Yeah, the kind of like I was mistreated as a child. Right. Like this, the whole different kind of origin.
But I don't know much about Kilgrave, so I don't know if it's, you know.
I feel like they did the same thing they did the Kingpin.
Right.
They gave him way more of a softer side.
Right, right.
And then there's, at certain points, you're almost on his side, and you're like, I should not be on his side, not even a little bit. This guy is a monster.
Yeah, that's the whole point, I think, of, in my opinion, of Kilgrave, is that he is a monster. I know in the comics, from what we understand, he does lose a wife, so that's like a tragic moment for him. But, I mean, even at that point, I don't think any time when you find that out that you're feeling sorry for Kilgrave. So, in here, I'm like, oh, she's maybe going to try to turn him into a hero. And that was all weird to me. That was really strange.
I think it was her trying to figure out a way to deal with him.
Sure. I mean, I get it.
I think she wanted to do the hero thing and was like, how do I hero this out?
Right.
How do I finish this as a hero? We walk away. Everybody's alive. And then we just, like, the bodies start piling up. She just had no other way and no other option.
Right.
We'll talk about that in a minute. I think Luke Cage was executed well.
Yeah, he did a good job. I mean, he looks like, I mean, you want to talk look. About look.
He's
like,
the look. He's the, he had the best delivery. He had the best and I think the worst delivery of Sweet Christmas.
They yeah, he twice. Had the best and the worst.
They did it twice. The first time.
The one in the bed was hilarious.
Mind-blowing. Like, mind-blowing. Like, I paused Christmas. The video. I paused the video and laughed my ass off. And then, the second time, was they find like a mountain of weed and he's like, Sweet Christmas. And I'm like, no. This was not a Sweet Christmas moment. Yeah. I've read Sweet Christmas moments. That is not a Sweet Christmas moment.
Yeah, no, that wasn't.
So I feel like that was like just done a little too far. I think they could have definitely just left it with the one mention and I've been perfectly happy with it.
You're right.
But otherwise, I mean, I don't think that's his fault. I think that's more of the writing.
That's the writing.
But I think
he did a good job.
He did a great job. I think, like I said, I think Patsy Walker, I'm sorry, Trish Walker, excellently portrayed. Yeah. Excellently portrayed. Yeah. I didn't know how they were going to go about it. For those of you who don't know, originally Patsy Walker was kind of like a glamour, not like a beauty comic, but it was kind of like a teenage romance comic.
Right.
And they evolved her as the Silver Age moved forward. They evolved her into a heroine. So I feel like if I remember my Marvel Chronicle right, they basically wanted a new female hero, didn't want to create a new one or couldn't create a new one. And they were like, oh, we have this model from back in the day. We're just going to use her, and now she's going to be a hero.
Right.
And basically saying that all of that stuff happened, where she was like that teenage heartthrob or all that stuff, which is kind of what we saw on the show. You have this whole Patsy Walker history of like, oh, she was on TV, she was, you know, a child star, and then she became a grown woman, and now she's a badass Krav Maga, which is the Israeli Mossad is what teaches that, and that's, they're killers, they're murderers, they're freaking amazing.
I mean, I honestly, I can't even talk bad about anybody's acting, man. I mean, even the twins, they did a good job playing those weirdo people.
I think,
like, as much as I didn't care for the characters, like, the people that played those characters did a good job. I
mean, I have to agree.
I don't think anybody did a bad job. There was a moment in the drug addict, the Power Ranger.
Yeah, he was a power. And that's the great ranger. Thing about that's it. A great like, thing. We're talking about acting. Yeah. I think that like to level. That's a level up right there.
Yeah, to transition from Power Rangers, which is clearly
there are a few people. Acting. There are a few people who have transitioned from Power Rangers. One being Liv on iZombie, which I didn't realize, and she's actually from the same series as him,
right.
Which I thought was crazy. But he did an excellent job.
He did a really good
because
job.
You know what? I was in the role with him.
Right.
I was not. Like, on occasion, I would find myself thinking, like, man, this guy was a Power Ranger?
Yeah.
But not like, oh, this is that guy from Power Rangers. Never.
Yeah.
You know, because the same thing with, like, Chris Evans in Captain America. Not once was I, like, Johnny Storm.
No,
because he was in there, and I was in there with him. I never thought anything about that.
Oh, no, absolutely. But that being said, I think overall he did a really good job, but there was one moment where he's trying to, like, tell the twin, like, what about, you know, my mom praying all the time, and that moment where he's talking about, you know, the good, you know, the, I don't know if you remember it, but...
Oh, yeah, yeah, so...
It felt really,
where she was
like,
kind of being, like...
She's being negative, and he's trying to...
Like, oh, like, what about all the prayer, you know, all the stuff I learned as a kid?
Yeah, yeah, like that part, it was...
It was a little forced, but...
It was a little forced.
Again, I think that's... Writing, like, yeah, unnecessary writing, like, that's that interchange wasn't necessarily,
because when he was a drug addict, he played that really well. Like, he was like this gloomy guy, like,
yeah. No, there was never
like he looked like he was done with life. Like, he did a good job playing that part.
And I think what was the next thing? Story.
Is that
to
what
go into going into the story? Him being that plant.
Oh,
I thought that was amazing.
Yeah.
I didn't see it.
I didn't see it coming either. No, they didn't. I thought he was just literally a drug addict. Because
I'm like, she's
living
in some, like, busted out town.
Yeah,
man. These are the people that are gonna be.
Yeah, and she, you know, she's hoping to help him out somehow. You
right,
know,
she's gonna help him
to
out
to get him past him.
I did find it weird that, like, both the times that she took him to his apartment, she kind of just, like, threw him in, closed the door.
I mean, yeah. I mean,
so that's why I thought it was weird. So then the first time she goes in, when she realizes what's going on, and she finds the paper, I'm like, if you just, like, walked him to his bedroom, you could have been fine. But, I mean, and I feel like the writing and the story aspect of that there is perfect, because Jessica, at that point, wouldn't have taken him in.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
She was like, half-assing her help.
Right, that's what I'm saying. Like, she wanted but to help, but at the same time, she didn't want to be bothered. So
right, it's one of those, like, moments where you look at it and you're like, you know, if, like, a week ago you had just gone in with him, we might be way further along in this.
Right. No, absolutely. But that being said, story. I think the story overall, just the entire story of Jessica Jones played out okay. I wouldn't say it was great. I wouldn't say it was good. It was okay. It was, there was some times where it was like, I don't know, it just felt like it was really dragging at some moments, you know. It looks like they took quite some time to show us some things, or, you know, show her capabilities, or show other people's capabilities. Like, the whole thing with dragging on with Luke Cage and his wife. Like, come on, that didn't need to happen that way. That was so dragged on. Because
the first time she ran away...
Yeah, you
think... I feel like the first time she ran away, they didn't show why she ran away. She saw the picture and she ran.
Right.
So we didn't have a flashback at that point.
No, we didn't have a flashback, but she saw the picture.
The next time,
so we knew it was something.
We saw a flashback. Right. And I was like, wait, what? And then it just kind of came together. But it was really, it was like 3 episodes later. And then by the time she told him, it was like another 3 episodes later.
Yeah, it was
like episode 7 or 8
when
we finally like resolved that. And then he was just gone for 5 episodes.
Yeah, and then he was just gone for 5 episodes.
So it was,
I don't know, I don't know. Just certain things of the story, it's... I don't know. It took too long. Here's the thing. When it comes down to between the two shows that they released, Daredevil, they changed my mind. Because when I said it originally, I said Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. wasn't doing a good job. They weren't doing a good job telling a story on Agents. And not just telling a story, but like really involving that part of the universe. You know, that particular... You know, I get it, they're Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., but it just felt like not a lot was happening. It took them a long time to actually get something going. With Daredevil, they did it fast. They went, and I'm like, okay, well, I mean, if they did this with Daredevil, I can't see it being any worse with Jessica Jones. If anything, they'll just be like, well, here's what we did with this, and people love it. Let's just go crazy with Jessica, right? But then it was like, I think because I was expecting that, that's why the story wasn't as good. It just really dragged on certain things that did not need to be dragged on.
I think there was definitely certain story elements that dragged out too long.
Right.
But I feel like overall, I think it was done well, told well. I don't think, for the major moments, I think all the major moments were good. I think maybe if they hadn't had sex right off the bat, maybe like 2 episodes before she told them they had sex.
Right.
If there was like maybe like a few episodes of flirting and then they have sex.
Well,
then she tells them like the next time, we still would have had the exact same reaction.
Right.
You would have had the same exact, you know, really, the entire conversation would have been the same.
Right.
Like, because he was mad that she had sex with him.
Right.
Also, This is going into the dialogue and writing. He said, "You let me be inside you." And that was the creepiest thing ever.
You found that really weird.
I was like, dude, like, that's a joke that you make. Like, my wife and I make dirty jokes all the time. And I'll say that. But, like, in jokes, he was ultra serious.
Right.
He was like, "You let me be inside you." And yeah, I'm like,
you really stuck on top of that. I don't know. There's a lot of things that I felt like there was, once again, going into the writing / story. Like the whole, as I was saying, the whole, like, the other twin, the chick, going, following the drug addict to their little meeting, overhearing everything, and then causing a rebellion against Jessica. That entire scene was completely unnecessary. That did not even have to happen.
Here's the thing. I think I understand why it happened and why they showed it. Because she brought this group together.
Sure.
But she brought them together to use them. To get information on Kilgrave, etc.
But they never used them. She
did. Every time she went there, every time she got information about it, she was there and then, like, he said something, one person would say a location, Like, the guy was like, oh, maybe be a chauffeur. And he's like, this is what, you know.
Well, that was before. That's when she was interviewing them all.
That was when they first had the group meeting. That was the first group meeting. But anyway, so what I'm saying is, it was a story point to show that because she brought this group together and didn't nurture any kind of relationship with them, that they flipped on her like that.
But I didn't care for it. Like,
I get why they did it. I didn't like it either. Don't get me wrong. I didn't like it either. I just think I get why they did it. I don't think it was a necessary thing.
I'm saying,
I think, like, you could have executed something different.
Yeah. For,
like, I think it could have just been the girl.
Yeah.
And she would have freed him. She ended up freeing him anyway.
Right.
But I think you needed that. You needed that to happen for the scene in the restaurant.
Yeah.
Because again, just to have like one person on a noose, not as good.
And Hope on the other one? I mean, whatever. I mean, regardless, I didn't need that scene. I think that scene was completely a waste of time, and I don't know. I think they could have done something else with that time. That's just, to me, was completely unnecessary to watch this psychopath, like, crazy, out-of-her-mind twin just all of a sudden randomly follow the drug addict somewhere for, like, there was no reason. There was not at one point that she was like, I'm feeling a little suspicious about him. I should follow him. It was just like, oh, I followed you to this meeting spot.
What? And then also, I don't know. I've never been in a support group. I've never been in a support group. But he, like, bares his soul. He's like, listen, there's a dead body. I, like, wrapped him in towels, took him, dropped him into the lake or the ocean or whatever.
I mean, listen, some.
And he just, like, blah, yeah, right? Word vomit.
Yeah.
And no one bats a fucking eyelash.
But because
they're like,
yeah, but at the same time,
because now we get it.
Yeah, they get it because they know what Kilgrave can do. That's the thing.
And then she just walks in and she's like, oh, blah, 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 you're my former friend. And I'm just like, wait.
Like,
you're mad that he lied to you? Not that your brother's dead?
Like, I don't know, man. It's just, to me,
and
it's
at the same time, the way they wrote her character, I think she executed it really well because I was genuinely kind of weirded out by her.
Yeah.
Because she's like, oh, where are his tiny little toes?
Right.
Where is his soul?
Yeah.
And I'm like, what the hell is wrong with you?
Yeah, listen, her being crazy, that's fine. Like I said, her character, the way she portrayed it, everything, it did what it needed to do to make me feel like this character is so freaking weird. But I don't know. I just didn't, like, that's just one of the part of the stories that I just didn't care about. Once again, the other part of the story was, like, the whole dragging out between her and Luke Cage. There was the whole, like, oh, we're seeing, I mean, I get we would see Kilgrave, and once again, I take this stuff with a grain of salt because I still look at this stuff with a like, it's a different universe. It's not the comics, you know. It's like you know, in DC you have Earth 1 and you have Earth 2, so this is like Earth 50. Like, I look at it, it's like it's just another variation of a story.
1999.
Whatever. I look at it that it's different variations of the story, so it's not going to be what we see in the comics. It never will. So that's fine, but, like, I don't know, the whole Kilgrave story with his parents, it was good, but I don't know, it was a weird, like, I don't know how I really, like, it. I have, a mixed feeling about it. Like, I get it. I understand it. It worked out good. It made sense. But at the same time, I'm like, maybe they could have went a little different route. I don't know. And the whole, like, the ending was really what kind of disappointed me. Because, one, they killed Kilgrave, which I was thinking, since it's going to be the Defenders at some point, they're going to need a few villains to be around.
You don't need a few. You just need a well-executed group of villains. Here's what they can do. Now that they have the Spider-Man rights, what they could do, they probably won't, but what they could do is do Wilson Fisk back out of prison or whatever, and his Sinister Six. Because he hires them, and if you remember the Spider-Man animated series from the 90s.
They won't.
He runs it like remotely.
Right, but they won't do that.
But I think that would be an interesting attack point.
I think there's a limit on how much they can do with Spidey on their contract because they don't have.
All right. Well, I mean, they have rights to include him in their stories.
Right. So I don't we'll know about see. We'll like see. Sinister Six or anything like that. But I don't
but,
know. I don't.
But
I,
you
I,
do
I,
get
I,
the flip side is now you can use Fisk in a Spider-Man.
Well, here's the thing. So what I was hoping they would have done is one, either the serum turns him in a purplish fashion. Like I said, he didn't have to be fully purple, but like right. There could have been aspects of him that were purple. Or when she. Like, the whole, like, oh, I'm going to fake it. I'm going to fake that he's able to control me again. I'm going to stand here. I'm going to smile.
That was good.
Then I'm going to grab him and snap his neck.
I think that was good.
It was good. It was really the only way you could do it. I mean, you can't... What, are you going to have an epic battle? You can't. You can't have an epic battle because he's a mind control and she's physical. So, like...
Right.
Like, you're not going to have...
No,
He's not, like, a badass physical combat... Guys, so like you're not gonna have it that way. So
it was
in that
always
aspect,
be
like
him throwing people at her,
right? So
and in, her figuring out, like her moving beyond her limitations of fighting,
right,
to beat him,
right? No, so in that aspect, I expected that was gonna be the way it was gonna have to end. But I figured, okay, so they're gonna snap his neck. All right, cool. So he dies. But I figured, okay, here's a little glimpse at the end. Where that IGH company grabs him and somehow revives him, and because they revive him, he's purple. Or he's, once again, has aspects of purple, whatever. He doesn't have to be full purple. And it could work out. It would look too cheesy. I get what some people would say, but I'm like, no, that's why they're filmmakers. They
well,
make
the,
it look
here's
good.
Here's the thing. So, we definitely know that we didn't see him at all after. So
we didn't.
You know, after he was on the ground, we didn't see him at all.
But that means he would have cheated death a second time.
Right.
But
here's the thing. He had an experimental drug in his system.
Yeah.
Anything could happen.
Anything.
Plus, they might have, if they had, if IGH is involved in any way.
Right.
They have the reds or whatever, which apparently heal you or at least get you up and going.
From almost anything.
Right, just about anything. Dude was almost dead, and they were like, here, pop this, and he was like, brr.
I'm going to kill everybody.
Right.
So I was hoping we'd see something. I was hoping, like, a little, like, gotcha moment, right? Like, now you got to wait.
I wanted it after.
But there was nothing. It was just like, all right, hello, can I help you? And
well, here's the thing. What I like is... As awful of a person as she was, which is another character that I didn't really touch on, is the lawyer, Hogarth. I think she was bringing that up. I think she was a terrible person.
She was a terrible person.
She played it excellently.
She did, but
I
honestly... I
always forget her name, but Trinity did a great job.
But at the same time, I didn't need that much of a story from her. I didn't need to see her having issues with her significant other. I didn't need to see that she was trying to get with another woman while she's dumping. I didn't need that backstory.
I understand that you didn't need it, but hear me out. I think I actually may be able to convince you as to why she was necessary. If you didn't have another kind of longer overarching story that you could pop in for the... I always forget the term they use, but the, like, weekly, the episodic kind of thing.
Okay.
If you didn't have something where you could touch on, because she hired her to, like, deliver the papers, she hired her to find dirt on her, you know, all this stuff. So, if you didn't have that, you would then have to have, kind of like, in the first one, where, oh, go deliver these papers to this jerk-off landlord.
Right.
And then, because of that, we had that one other crazy couple. But you would have that every episode.
Sure.
If you didn't have, like, another overarching story. So, because you had these two longer, three, really, overarching stories, you had kind of that episodic format without having a new kind of, like Smallville is a great example of that. You had the overall Smallville story, but then you had the freak of the week.
I get where you're coming from. It's just, that being said, it could have been done differently. It was just another story. Listen, we had Patsy, we had Nuke, we had...
Well, we had that story. That's what I'm saying. That was the third story I'm talking about. The Patsy slash Nuke story is the third story that it's
right, like, but what I'm saying is we had those. We had Luke Cage. Now on top of that, there's Trinity. Too much. There's a lot. Like that could have there's a lot but of like there's somebody. A lot of like, oh, this is what's going on. It's a conversational thing. It's a superhero show. I want more.
It's not a superhero show. It's a PI show.
Then why, you know, the man Murdoch should have been constantly in court.
They did a lot of court stuff. They did a lot of lawyer stuff.
Yeah, but it did not nowhere near like this. Nowhere near.
But that was
like
but that
this.
Was also very much. Here's the thing: they're two very different characters. Like I said at the beginning, I think Jessica Jones is a character who is trying to live a normal life, happens to have powers.
Right.
Daredevil was somebody who was like, "I'm gonna go out and seek justice."
No, I get it. I get that they're not the same. Happen to be a lawyer. I'm not asking for the same thing. I'm talking about. You got people like Luke Cage, who's indestructible. You got people like Jessica Jones, who can stop a car. A slow-moving car, but she can stop a car. I mean, it like... I don't know. I didn't get any kind of excitement out of this. Like, any kind of crazy excitement out of this story.
Not even the fight with Harry Cage?
That was literally episode 11, 12.
Right, but
out
I mean,
of
13. Like... I mean, like, what did you have on Daredevil? You had, like... little fights with random guys, and then the actual fights were in the last two episodes.
Yeah, but I mean, you had a lot of fights with random guys. That's the thing. He had fights with cops. He had fights with criminals. He had fights on top of fights with other more fights, and he was always bleeding and stuff.
It was a different approach.
It's a different approach. I'm just saying, like, I needed. I guess she's a detective. I get that, or a PI. I get that, but it's like. Even that aspect of it, even the PI aspect of it, wasn't always as played out well as it should have been. Like, you know, getting clues and stuff. I feel like it could have been done in a way better fashion.
It was realistic, though. I mean, that's from what I understand, that's how PIs work. They sit somewhere waiting to take pictures of someone, and then when they get the pictures, all right, give me my money, here are your pictures. That's really the end of it.
Sure.
Like, the...
I mean, there's more detective work than that. I mean, you got to figure out where they're going to go, where they're going to meet.
Often not, man. People are pretty fucking simple. In the long run, people are pretty straightforward.
I mean, that's fine. Like I said, to me, I'm not here to convince you, and you're not here to convince me. This is my perception of
it. You wanted it to be more of a superhero show.
Not necessarily more of a superhero show. I just wanted more. I wanted more out of it. I needed more excitement out of it. It didn't have enough excitement where it hooked me like Daredevil.
And I think that goes into the cinematography. I think that goes into some of the shots. Because something that you were trying to tell me from the beginning is, oh, they're avoiding showing her power.
Not just hers. Luke Cage's, too, on certain aspects.
And... you know, they're avoiding showing her jumping, and the whole time I'm like, what do you want to see? You just want to see her, like, I guess, just like a black background jumping in the night? Like, that's boring. It's boring as shit. Whereas, then I thought, like, later on, when she left, Wilson? Is it Wilson? Yeah.
I'm trying to think of the scene you're trying to speak
about.
Frank. Simpson?
Simpson, that's the one.
Nuke. Right.
She left Simpson... and she jumps with Kilgrave on her back.
Yeah, but they just, like, focus
and
on
it was just
face.
Like, they're like, oh.
Yeah, she disappears off the screen.
Golly,
and
she
like,
jumped.
Did that just happen?
And I'm like.
Did what just happen?
and all I was saying, because he's like, you see they're avoiding it. I'm like, well, I mean, you saw it. I'm like, what else do you see? I'm like, the only thing I could think of is, like, if they had just, and this I think is a simple shot. I can't imagine this is hard. Just follow her up.
Yeah, that's it.
It's still going into the dark, have her disappear into the dark.
Right.
And you're kind of like, that's a cool shot, all right.
Yeah. That's what I was trying to say. Like, it was avoidance and laziness, in my opinion, because it's lazy to, oh, okay, she's just going to disappear off screen and we're going to keep the camera here and focus on you guys being awed by this. That's lazy. You should show the shot. Like, she has this superpower capability
here's
of jumping
thing.
Really far at the current moment. She does fly from what you've explained to me in
the
comic.
Yeah, in the comic she flies.
So at the current moment, she can jump like crazy. Well, at least show that. Like, don't. And
here's,
then, and then it wasn't until like what, 10? 10 is when the first time we see her actually falling down to the ground.
The guided falling,
right?
Or what you call
the guided falling that she says.
But here's the thing. I this just came to me. So hear me out for a second. I feel like this show, because it is not meant to be the superhero show, it's not meant to be, and it's not really meant to be an action show. They, if you look at all of it, not just those shots, there's even all the fights. There wasn't like a lot of fast camera following the fight, right?
Right.
It was this shot of he's jumping and it's like punch,
right?
And then the next shot of him landing,
right?
It was a lot of quick cuts like that,
yeah.
As opposed to you look at something like Supergirl, which I know a lot of people have been comparing the two shows. I think both shows are good. I think Jessica Jones is better. Just if you're just looking at purely acting, I think
purely acting, way better. Jessica Jones is better.
I think overall they're good. I think they both have their own charms.
Yeah, absolutely. I like both shows.
Oh, whereas on Supergirl, you've got, because it's an action kind of show, it's sure, a more fast paced thing. You see her punch, and then the camera follows the punch into the guy and him falling into the
right,
whatever. So it's like more of an action based film style. So I could see why. I still don't like it. I still wish they would have done that to follow just like the little extra.
Like a little extra. I'm not talking about like I want to see her hopping across the sky. No,
right.
I don't need
like,
that.
I read
like,
something online where they were talking about, oh, the fights in Jessica Jones seem way more real. Again, when comparing to Supergirl.
Sure.
They feel real. And I'm looking, as I was watching it, because for whatever reason that stuck in my head, as I'm watching it, because of those quick cuts, I was like, no, nah, not really.
Not really, no.
Like, this is a quick cut, like, it's kind of an obvious fake punch.
Yeah.
I feel like there was only a few moments where you got a real sense of her power.
Right.
Because she's really strong.
Right.
And I think that there was a
but
few
But you don't
moments
always...
Where,
it's because she is always strong, like you're saying, you don't, like, there were a lot of fights that happened that really was like, that's it? Like, that, like, she... I expected a little more out of her
right,
because of her
well,
strength.
Well, it's like she punches
know?
People in the face, and some people stay down, some people don't.
Right.
But I'm like, well, is she, like, not quite good with, like, how strong she... Because she can, obviously, she can punch a dude's chest out.
Like, right. She can like, punch she you out of your life. She could kill Luke Cage's wife by
right,
punching her straight in the chest with full strength. So I get it if she's holding back, but at the same time, like... Why don't
like
you just not? Why don't you just
levels?
Right, like is like you didn't.
It
really,
was just kind of like
it
a
was,
weird thing.
That was once again that bad bad directing slash writing because, like, okay, is she not? Does she not know what the right punch is to knock somebody out? Because there are certain situations you punch them hard and they're out.
Well, because
and
there was a couple shots where she was like, she's right here, and she's like, bah, and the guy's out.
Yeah,
and I'm like, oh, okay, well, I mean, that's up. Why aren't you just mopping the floor with
right,
these normal
why
people?
Aren't you like? Why don't you just
like the only person that should have been able to put up a fight and he did, but he was even jacked up on drugs was Nuke.
You're right,
and that's because he's a military trained fighter.
He's a military
like,
fighter.
He should
and he's
be
on
able
drugs
to fight
that are given him beyond super or beyond human strength. So
right,
like, I mean, he threw her through a wall. Let's
right,
be serious.
Right.
So
I think that should her and him and Luke Cage should have been the only two that would have stood a chance. But she had some longer fights with a lot of these, you know, lower
normal
guys.
Just normal people, yeah.
Right. And normal people, not even like fighters, not
right,
even like
right, just normal
you know, not even like goons.
Yeah.
It was just people who were under his control.
Yeah.
And then you're kind of looking at like, well, okay, well, she knocked that guy out, but this guy's getting back up. Like, but that guy's not.
Right.
I didn't see like a major difference in the punch.
But yeah, no, there was it was
I feel like that's a lot of that's directing, a lot of that is kind of the
cinematic. It's the film, yeah, it's right, the filmmaking aspect of it. It's,
so I feel like if they polish that, kind of give us a real sense of her power level. Cuz that was the thing and we actually looked it up. Is she stronger than Luke Cage? She's not.
No.
But Luke Cage, there was not a single moment where you thought, I don't know how strong this guy is.
Right.
Every single interaction where it came to like strength and power,
right?
It was very much.
I mean, overall,
this guy is strong.
Right.
He can knock out your life,
right?
And there was no question about that. Whereas with Jessica Jones, sometimes you're like, all right, cool, she can, because like she takes that hit from that truck,
yeah,
and boom, what gets up, and she took a 2x4 to the head. Granted, it's a more direct shot; it's to the head. She's not invulnerable.
But
not even close.
No, not invulnerable, but like
she just heals faster.
You're telling me so this giant truck that didn't even stop, she says it. The asshole didn't even break because there's no skid marks.
Right.
So she got hit full force by a truck, right? And she woke up within a second. Let's say a minute she
right,
was out. But you're talking about this twin that's petite, looks like barely holding the 2x4, knocks her over the head so hard that like she's out for like a day.
She was out for a while.
Like, but what?
Here's the other thing about that.
This is what I'm talking about, the filmmaking aspect.
You can do that. Here's the thing. You can knock someone out where they're going to be out for a while.
Sure, yeah.
But I feel like this is like prop design. The people involved in that scene did not do their job.
No.
Because the 2x4 she had was almost bigger than her.
Right.
And I'm like, you can't swing that.
I was going to say, she swung that hard enough to knock her out.
Yeah, you can't swing. You don't have the leverage to swing
that. And fast enough for her not to be able to stop it or block it with her arm? I mean, come on.
You don't have the leverage to swing that with enough force to knock someone out, let alone knock her out.
And then also, going back to that part of it, you know, talking about knocking out, look at, like, the whole Luke Cage thing. He survived an explosion, and you're telling me a shotgun knocked him out for an episode. Invulnerable, an explosion, walks out,
that was sweet chin music. That was sweet. It was right there. It was point of impact.
I don't care. An explosion.
Bro, I can roll you. If I throw you down the stairs, you could get up. If I punch you right in your jaw, you could be out for a while.
I mean, you're hoping I can get out from throwing me down the steps. People die falling down the steps.
Maybe
so,
not these stairs. There's a lot of turns and stuff.
But what I'm saying I'm sorry. I can't.
People have survived.
People have survived
getting hit by a car.
Okay, but I'm talking about an explosion that took.
I'm saying equivalent force. So like a normal human being, like you could probably survive getting hit by a car. But again, like survive and like be conscious. It's happened. People have walked away from cars.
Okay, that's fine. But I'm.
If somebody was to knock you in your face,
sure,
you're out cold for hours.
I still can't accept it.
So it's. I think it's point.
You're telling me her punch that kills a person could knock him out. But a shotgun and an explosion, he's cool. A shotgun to the sweet chin music knocks him out. But her punch that takes your soul out of your body.
Well, not out of his body.
I'm assuming that punch is stronger than what that shotgun did to his chin. So if she punched him in the face, in the chin. Yeah, no, I'm sorry. Sorry.
I think it had a room for improvement. I think it was a cool way to exit that scene.
There's a lot of filming errors in this show.
I think it was a cool way to exit the scene, but again, because we didn't have a clear measurement of her power.
Right, we definitely didn't.
Because there was something, like, when they were doing it, she held his arm. She held him down.
Yeah, she held
him
down.
And I'm like, all right, well, maybe she's stronger than him, but right. I'm like, I don't think she's stronger than him.
I don't think, right.
But yeah, it was very much a lack of parameters. You can't, you know, like for the Hulk is as strong as he needs to be.
Yeah.
Regardless of the situation. If you guys have a chance to read the original Secret Wars, he holds up literally a mountain, just like this.
Right.
Catches it on his back. Everybody else underneath him, he's just like, nope, I got this, guys.
Right.
And that's like we don't know how strong he is, but it's like, there is no upper limit.
Right, there's like,
we know that he's ridiculous.
Right, whatever he needs, he's that strong. So
whereas with her, you just don't know what her lower or upper level is.
No.
So you're going to tell me that she can lift a car, okay. She can catch a car at speed, if you remember.
Yeah, what is
the
she?
The little girl, which I feel was Kilgrave. The little girl that went into traffic, I feel was Kilgrave.
I mean, maybe.
In that flashback. Because it seemed like, why was that little... Because she just stood there.
Right.
And I'm like, I feel like he was watching, and that's why she looked at her. She said something weird. But she, like, caught it.
Yeah, she stopped.
Caught it, moved like an inch.
She did say slow moving. But that's not slow moving, though.
I mean, it might have been going 35.
I mean, I guess. Because like, he might have been trying to stop last minute. So.
Right. So, yeah, he was already on his brake or whatever, but she stopped it. So, let's say it was moving 15 miles an hour.
Right.
So, she caught a moving car. So, she's got a lot of strength in her legs. She's got a lot of power in her body. But then, you're going to tell me she can't knock out any single person she punches? Like, that's why I didn't like...
No,
that's what I didn't like about that. Again, it's that defined power level.
No.
If you're gonna do that, if you're gonna be like, well, we're not sure, and you're gonna kind of play around with it, at least at some point say that she's trying to figure out how not to hurt people or something.
Yeah, I mean, I think because something
about the powers themselves.
Well, here's the thing: she, from we know because of the flashback, she's known about her powers for a very long time. So I'm assuming she's been practicing on her levels for a very long time.
You would think so.
So I still don't understand if that's the case, if that's what I'm to presume from what you filmmakers showed me in this 13 episodes, for me to presume that she is able to control her power properly enough to knock somebody out or not to knock somebody out. So why, every time she's in a fight with just a normal person, she just does it and knocks them out?
Right?
Just like when Luke Cage was like, listen, if I punch you, you're going to die. So I'm going to slap you across the head and you're going to fly across my bar. Like, it's like, I don't know. I just feel like they really, it was a lot of, when it comes down to the filmmaking,
a lot of undefined
directing, and just a lot, you know, storytelling of this show, there was a lot of things that were just amiss. And that's unfortunate, because I didn't feel that way almost at all with Daredevil. And I said almost, because there were maybe slight little bit, but nothing to this extent.
Sure.
So to come from a first series that you created on Netflix, which was Daredevil, and for everybody to absolutely love it.
Right.
And personally, I mean, I never thought Daredevil was as good as some other people did. I still thought it was very good, just not holy crap good.
See, here's the thing. I think both these shows are really great. I mean, like, above great.
Yeah.
When you compare them to other TV shows.
Sure, absolutely.
Because other TV shows aren't that good.
Right, right.
Like, because here's the thing. Netflix is kind of a bridge between film and TV.
Right.
Because they have a little bit higher budget. Yeah. They're more concise. Oh, we're going to do 13 episodes. It's going to be a direct story.
Yeah.
We're not stretching it out. We don't... Like, on Agents, you had 22 episodes in season one. Really, 13 would have been just aces.
Right.
If you'd have like, oh, it starts mid-season and it finishes whenever, I'd have been fine
Yeah, you know? I mean, it's...
It would be a more concise season.
Absolutely.
You wouldn't need all this, like, dragging stuff out. And that's why the Netflix shows are better. So that's why I think people who watch a lot of TV are like, oh, man, Daredevil's crazy.
Right.
Like, even my wife. My wife said... My wife, not me, my wife said...
I was like...
Besides Guardians and Iron Man... Which I wholly agree with. Not in that order necessarily, but I wholly agree.
Even, right.
This is the best thing Marvel's put out. Besides Guardians and Iron Man, this is the best thing Marvel's put out. That's what my wife said.
Nobody said that we said that.
My point is, my wife watches a lot of TV. I think she's watched some dumb amount of Law & Order SVU seasons. She watches a lot of TV, a lot of TV shows, stuff like that. So she has that comparison, and she went straight to the top with it. Like, oh my God, it's like three episodes in, she was in love.
No,
she's like, this show is great. It's so good. And I'm like, yeah, it's great. Like, it's a good show.
It's a good show.
Like, it's a good show.
It's not that good.
I don't think it's like mind-blowing.
It's not
right?
that good.
I think they executed a lot of things well.
I think for 13 episodes, there was a lot of dragging out.
Right. You could have been a lot more concise.
Episodes,
here's
for
the thing.
13
you
episodes,
had,
that was a lot of dragging
you
out.
You had Kilgrave in custody four times?
Oh my God, yeah.
Four times you had him tied up, wrapped up in, with a bow.
Right.
With a bow. And somehow we still had to go out to like a last confrontation.
Right.
At the end. And I'm just like, wait, what?
Yeah, no, it's just, it's...
Like,
it's
oh, he's
it's
caught.
A lot of...
I was like, all right, cool, they got him. And then, like, they somehow, you said...
Well, I called it. Like, I said what was going to happen
well,
with
the lawyer.
Well,
the lawyer.
Yeah, I called that the minute!
Also, that lawyer is so awful that she put her love of her life, the woman she wants to spend the rest of her life with, under the bus.
Yeah.
She's like, no, you chose to pick that thing up and crush her head. And I was like...
Yeah.
She saved your fucking life,
she bitch! She saved your life. She is part of your love life, right?
Right.
She's supposed to be the person you love, the person you left
and
somebody...
And she looks at her dead in the eye.
And she
says,
you chose
guard
them.
I need my lawyer. He's like, she said she was your lawyer. I've never seen this woman in my life.
Which is not true, like, because you work for her. You're in love with her.
I'm like, I get the idea of what
she's trying
to do.
Right, right. I get what she's trying to say.
But you work for her.
Right.
And they're like, you're in pictures together and shit. Like,
but we get it. Clearly, you know. We get it. But I don't know. I don't have much more to say. It was a good series.
I think it was a good series. I think I watched this way faster than I watched Daredevil.
That's true, but I don't know why we took so long. I mean, I watch a lot of other things, so.
You know, actually, you know what? I think I know why. There was only two other shows this week.
Yeah,
Supergirl and Gotham were the only other two shows this week.
That's why.
And before, we were also doing the reviews.
Yeah.
When Daredevil came out, we were still doing weekly reviews. Yeah. So we were watching six shows a week.
No, absolutely.
And reviewing them all.
I just, there was more, there was, Daredevil is way better than this. For a main reason is just because there was more in return at the end, in the middle, like, oh, he has this black costume. Oh, towards the end, he gets this awesome Daredevil costume.
Still like that costume. I don't care what y'all guys say.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think it's
I'm excited
great
for
costume.
The season 2 costume, but I think I still like the end of season 1 costume.
Yeah, absolutely. I was perfectly happy with that costume. But Daredevil is a better story than Jessica Jones when it comes down to how it was done. When how it was done, Daredevil was a better show.
Yeah, as far as execution, absolutely.
Yeah, execution, that's what I mean.
Absolutely, and I think we agree on that. I think a lot of the problems with this show, with Jessica Jones, is execution, the cinematography, just certain directorial and production choices.
Like, there were so many small little things that could have been adjusted, and it would have made it so much better.
Absolutely.
But, I mean, I personally still think it's a good show. I can't wait to see... I am scared, but I can't wait to see what they do with Luke Cage. We have found out that it takes place after Jessica Jones.
I want to clarify that. I'm going to interrupt you for a second. I want to clarify the timeline. There is a lot of talk on the internet as to how these things happen.
Right.
So Daredevil, because of, and I didn't catch this, but I'm gonna take the internet's word on this. In like episode 10 or 11, there's a mention of like a lower character on, like a lower importance character on Agents.
Sure.
That was like some sort of reference.
Right.
So you can tell that it kind of takes place before the end of season 2.
Sure.
This happens after Daredevil.
Right.
I'm presuming pretty quickly after Daredevil.
I would say it's pretty
I don't see why it wouldn't.
Although I'm surprised there was no like mention of Wilson Fisk or something, because that was a fairly major thing that happened in the same city.
I feel you, and it's the same borough. Like
the same
area of New York in Hell's Kitchen. But I think the reason for that is that in this, I don't think there was a single mention of like organized crime. This is very much like an individual, like this is a person to person, like single, you know, petty crime violations. Yeah. You know, so that's kind of what she's working with. And then you've got this massive.
But
villain.
we should have seen some things like a newspaper clipping or.
We did get the references to the Avengers. There are no references to Sokovia.
Right.
Which means that it likely takes place before Age of Ultron.
Yeah, that's what I've been saying since the show started. I said
I don't know how I feel about that necessarily. I really don't know how I feel about that.
Well,
I like the inclusion of Claire.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think it's weird that they have her mom is going to be on
Luke Cage.
Yeah. Well, he's going to Harlem.
He's going to Harlem, so
I feel like they're going to bring that in, bring more history in. I like the I think the villain is going to be the guy from.
Although I don't know how I feel about him going to Harlem, considering this is supposed to be taken in Hell's Kitchen.
But his barge just blew up.
I understand that, but
so he's got to go somewhere.
I get that, but it's supposed to take place in Hell's Kitchen.
But he's still on the run.
I get that. It's still supposed to take place in Hell's. Like that doesn't.
It's
change
not supposed
the
to. Luke Cage is not supposed to take place in Hell's Kitchen. It's in New York. It's in New York. Series.
I mean, that's fine. Anyway, I'm just saying.
Anyway, so this happens after because Claire talks about, oh, you're not my first special.
Right, you're not my first, like, we're not going to my apartment because I already done that once.
Yeah, been there, done that, lost my lease. So that's after.
So it's definitely after Daredevil. It's after Daredevil.
Yeah, it's after the majority of it.
But it's definitely before Age of Ultron. So Like I said, yeah, I mean, so, you said, you know, here's the thing.
And that might mean that Luke Cage also happens before Age of Ultron. Right. Which then, where does Defenders happen? Also, season two of Daredevil is going to be happening, I think, before even Luke Cage.
Right. Well, here's the thing. So, I mean, the reason
Maybe after Luke Cage.
I mean, they said they have a specific reason or there a specific time when they need Defenders out. And I'm assuming that's because of Infinity War. Is that what they call it?
Well, Infinity War is like 2019, 2018.
But when's the Defenders coming out?
I don't think there's a date.
There isn't a date because we got Luke Cage.
Luke Cage is next year.
Then we still have to do Iron Fist.
We're going to do Daredevil season two probably next year.
And then Iron Fist.
Probably 2017.
Right. We might not see the Defenders till 2017, which will get us then close to Infinity War. Which would make sense.
So you're saying Luke Cage might happen after Age of Ultron. Which then you have a lot more pressure if the Sokovia Accords are signed, depending on what happens in Civil War. We don't know yet.
Right.
Depending on if that's signed, if that is like enacted somehow, he might be even more on the run. He might be trying to avoid using his powers. So that's why, you know, he's at a barbershop, yeah, not at a bar.
It's tough to say.
Less fights to get into.
It's tough to say because I get what they're doing. They're trying to tell these stories of these four characters in a close manner so they can get them to be in Defenders at the same time. So I get why Jessica Jones would have to be before Age of Ultron. But at the same time, then a lot of people that are paying attention to this, but not as closely as we are, they're going to be like, oh, well, isn't that supposed to be after Ant-Man and Age of Ultron? And it's like, well, you would assume, but if you actually look at it, how they're trying to do it,
right.
There's a reason why it takes place, but some people that are just people who watch shows and they're like, okay, well, this comes out after this, so it's supposed to be after this, but it's not, so... Right. I think there's a reason for it. There's a reason why they're telling it that way because obviously, Defenders is then supposed to take place, and you know what they deal with, how they deal with it, especially after Civil War.
My only beef with this whole setup is I feel because of the way they did this one, they did Daredevil. You had the entire season set up for the last like 2 to 3 episodes,
right.
And the same thing happened here. Again, you didn't have her powers really being displayed a lot.
Right.
You didn't have... The major fight was in episode 12. So a lot of that stuff happened at the end of the season. I feel like Defenders is going to be 6 to 8 episodes of them coming together, figuring out if they're going to be a team or not. And then like 9 and 10 is going to be like, all right, we're going to be a team. And then like 11, 12, and 13 is going to be
we're
going to fight the bad guys.
I'm not going to lie. I was hoping that, okay, at the end of each show, right? So at the end of season 1 of Jessica Jones, she meets Daredevil. Right,
yeah, like, some sort of connection.
They're like some kind of connection.
Claire.
You got Claire.
What if Claire brings them together? What if Claire's
she probably will.
She's the Rick Jones of
Defenders.
Let's
be serious. That's probably what's going to happen because she said, "Oh, I got a guy. Do you want to see if he can help?" Because she said that.
Yeah, she did.
So she probably will be the main factor in bringing them together, but that means in Defenders, at least the first 3-4 episodes, they're going to be like figuring this out and trying to get together.
Here's what I want. I want the villain. I want the villain of the Defenders to be tied into Iron Fist somehow. At least partly.
Right.
Also, for any, just like a little sidebar, for anyone who thinks that Iron Fist should be Asian, you're wrong. You're just wrong.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Danny Rand is not really going to be Asian. It could be.
It could be.
I'm not saying it can't be. I'm just saying you shouldn't do it because the entire kind of concept of that is the juxtaposition of this blonde white kid.
Right.
And everything that he's part of is entirely in Asian culture.
Yeah.
So I think it'd be great for us as viewers to be introduced to that way.
Yeah, absolutely.
There's just a lot of really great stuff that you could do with it. Besides, I want Shang-Chi to be the first Marvel Asian, like, main Asian hero.
Now, here's the thing. Like,
which they could still bring into
this. As much as I mentioned earlier, like, yes, this is technically a different universe. I mean, there's no reason to change the character. Like... He's literally... The whole point of Iron Fist is that he's this white kid that's trying to fit in this Asian culture and accept this training that he's going to get. And there's... Then I believe his, like... is it technically his stepbrother? Is that what it is?
Yeah, I mean, his I guess he's his brother, kind of.
Right. He's like, he doesn't like him, right? Is that?
No,
it?
Yeah, yeah. They're like, mad rivals. Yeah, they're yeah, mad they're rivals. Rivals. And he's,
because and he's mad of that situation.
The guy's upset with him because Danny does get the Iron Fist.
He gets the Iron Fist, which, even though he doesn't feel that he's deserving because he's not part of their culture. He's not part
of... he's not like, looking he's for not, it. He's not... Right. And that's the word. You know, it's kind of the... It's the same thing they're going to do with Doctor Strange and Mordo.
Right.
Mordo is going to be like, oh, I'm going to be the Ancient One. And Doctor Strange is like, no, he's going to kill you. Like, I just... Like, I don't want to be part of this, but he's going to kill you.
Regardless, you're absolutely right. Whoever thinks that Danny should be Asian is wrong.
But anyway, I feel sorry. Like they should... I think in Iron Fist, they should have... him trying to fight some major villain.
Right.
And he's just going to be like, I can't do this by myself. And then at the end, like the last three episodes, he should like trip on them as he's going through New York.
That would be cool. But
he's
I
like,
mean,
run, he runs around the corner, runs into, literally runs into Jessica.
Here's the thing. That would be awesome.
These are all free, Marvel. These are all
these
free.
These are you free. Take, I'm not even going to charge you.
Take it and run with it.
Here's the thing. We've had so many good ideas the way they should have done stuff for Jessica Jones that like, I'm not surprised if that doesn't happen at all right now because of Jessica Jones.
Like, oh,
once
oh,
again, it's not a bad stuff, series. It's just not as good. It's just not as good as we definitely thought they were gonna go with. So,
I'm excited for Daredevil season 2.
Yeah,
I'm excited for Luke Cage. Definitely, I really, really, I've always been a big fan of Luke Cage.
Right.
I'd love to see this kind of play out on TV. It looks like we're going to get flashbacks of his origin.
We're definitely
I kind of want them
flashbacks.
To do it differently. I don't want them to I definitely don't want them to wait till the end of the season.
Right.
But I think Jessica Jones handled that, I think, really poorly. I wanted to know that stuff right off the bat.
Yeah, there's no reason why the first three episodes didn't tell us the story.
I would have liked the first half of the season to give us like the origin flashbacks. Yeah, yeah. And then the rest of flashbacks could have been where she's like training, right, or kind of like goes to a junkyard. Because he was telling him, he was saying about that, oh, I went to a junkyard and just started punching stuff or whatever until
right.
I figured out what could hurt me or what I couldn't do.
Right.
And I'm like, why didn't we get that from her? Why didn't we get like a flashback sequence of this girl, like in a fight in school?
Right.
And like, I mean, knocks someone's teeth out and she's like, whoa,
episode,
I gotta chill.
In episode like 10. Which is literally the last three episodes, we get to see her in her stepmom's house where she breaks the sink and then lifts it over her head. But I'm like, that's literally the ending of the series.
Yeah,
like, why didn't
definitely...
you do that in the beginning? Tell us a little bit more about that. But, I mean,
overall,
listen,
I think it was good. I think it was a good show. I think it was done well. I think it was acted wonderfully, well, pretty much everyone.
Yeah, everybody did a good job acting. There's no complaint on that.
The only beef I've got with it is
the story.
Cinematography, the execution really is the problem.
Yeah, the execution of the and the, certain things written in the story, like the way they were like, oh, you're going to do this and this type
right.
of deal.
It's,
so.
It's the, yeah, I mean, some of the extras, some of the stuff that took you away from the main storyline. The whole thing with the crazy couple, where she's like, oh, like I lost my mother in
oh yeah, 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 yeah,
she,
yeah.
So she lost her mother in the attack in New York, and she's out to like kill Jessica Jones.
She blamed it on the superhuman heroes,
right? On the specials
instead of
or
the aliens that came and destroyed everything.
And she has this really great display of just like breaking stuff, and then she gives her this really dumb. I feel like really dumb because there's nothing to back it up.
Oh yeah,
because she's like, says, how many of you are there out there? And she's just standing there. She's like, 99.
Yeah.
Last I counted, I had 99 friends with abilities.
Right.
And I was like, where is this coming from? Like, it was just like a random nondescript number.
Like the way I'm thinking about it is the 99 red balloons stung or yeah,
and just like stuff like just, that. Like. I thought you could have built that into something, but it was just...
Yeah, and then she was like, you know, my parents died, and do you see me killing every... Which, now that I think about that, that makes no sense, because she said that her parents died in an accident, and she's like, do you see me killing all the drunk drivers out there? I'm like, what does that have to do? Your dad turned around and hit a truck.
What? I think that was the point. Your mom was killed in an attack, so you're gonna blame someone who like is ancillary, like connected to that.
Right.
So like my parents died in a car accident, so I'm gonna attack. Like I'm gonna take it out on people who cause car accidents.
True.
Like okay. Any people.
Oh,
like,
I see. I see.
You know what I'm saying? So
I
like,
thought for some reason I thought she said drunk drivers or something. And I'm like.
No, she did say, but she's just saying.
But like, as in general, yeah, like that's so she's who causes saying, accidents.
Yeah, so she's basically saying that like you're blaming us for an attack on New York.
Yeah, I got you.
Where it'd be the same if I was blaming, you know, all drunk drivers my dad being a bad driver.
No, absolutely. Listen, to finish it off, this is already going long enough.
Oh my god,
it's a good story. It's a good the acting out of everybody, even though some of the characters we didn't care for.
Yeah.
Everybody did a great job.
Absolutely.
David Tennant definitely took it. He stole the show, in my opinion.
Yeah.
The
most definitely.
The biggest thing I think for us is it was dragged on. Most definitely. Lemon pepper. some of the stuff was dragged on. Some of the stuff wasn't necessary, and they really just didn't have that hook. That like, boom, I got you all the way from the beginning till the end, and here's this, like, special moment at the end.
I feel like there were at least three or four episodes where you kind of had to, like, choke down half the episode.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
But otherwise, I think good show, definitely worth the watch. If you're a Marvel fan, no question about it.
Yeah.
Even if you're not, if you just want to watch
a show.
Yeah, it's such a good show. I think it's definitely worth the watch. Yeah, I mean, not too much negative. I hope that with Luke Cage, they kind of give us a little more action, a little more directness. Yeah. And I know they've been having some issues with Iron Fist, and I hope that they work all that out and just exit. I want them to execute Iron Fist so wonderfully because I would love to see that spiritual, mystical side of the Marvel Universe is something they're going into.
Right.
So I want them to explore that. I feel like that might be why they've been having problems because they're trying to work it all in.
Yeah,
because it's definitely a mystical thing. And with Doctor Strange, that's going to be a mystical thing. So I feel like they're going to wait to see how Doctor Strange does to see how they're going to execute Iron Fist.
Yeah, no, absolutely. But yeah, that's it.
That's all I got to say. Appreciate you guys for watching. If you liked the video, hit that thumbs up down below.
Make sure to subscribe.
Make sure to subscribe if you have not subscribed yet. Share the videos, all that good stuff. Check out Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. We're all over the place.
We got a giveaway going on that we released about almost 2 months ago now.
Yeah.
Check out that video.
We're almost there. We're like 75% there. So as soon as we hit 500, we're going to be giving away a ton of gaming stuff.
Check out the video. So all the information is in there. All the information's on there. Just follow what we say on there, and it's a big giveaway. So
it's a huge giveaway. Hopefully, people get some games. But yeah, appreciate you guys watching. Any questions on your thoughts on the show down below? Please let us know what you think of the show.
Yeah,
what do you think of the Marvel Netflix universe? Is that what we're gonna call it?
Whatever.
It's all the Marvel Cinematic Universe. If you're gonna watch it in order, it's a hell of a lot of shows to watch. Not a lot of TV to watch.
A lot of movies.
But yeah, I'm excited for Civil War. We'll talk about that another time.
Yeah.
As always, I've been Dalibor.
Haris.
Signing off.